So you think you have me on your side. And I got news for you, I work out overtime to get away from thunder, stay away from lies. I won't listen to you criticize. I said again. Question carefully all of your intentions. Well, I've decided that I want the sun, cause your words only bring division. Well, that's it. Sometimes we go through hard times, through trials and tribulations. And in those hard times and through those trials, we've got to remember that we have a Father in heaven who longs to hold us and to help us through that tough time. We keep our eyes on him during that time. Not only will he help us through that struggle and through that time of pain, but at the end of it, he's going to make us stronger. Amen. All 40 days. Here I am in what feels like the end. So I come to you, my Lord, again. With this burden buried deep within, this heart that you have made. In this trial that I'm going through, come on. I don't question, cause I know it's true. Back to you, you have made me stronger. From this bang of 40 days and 40 nights, down the road of a minute trials, and I pray it's only for the season. It's in the world and that's an end of the flood. You're the one I thank you, Lord, and I know you got me for a reason. Thing I've got to say before they try to take my life away. Let it be known that I am not afraid that you will be done, Lord. But it's been 40 days and 40 nights,
The idea for Come Together is something that, to me, really came from our fans.
We felt like we, on tour, were getting a kind of a picture of what it meant for the church to, you know, unite.
There was a moment we used to do in our shows during the song "My Hope Is You," where Mac would get the crowd to to join hands and raise them up in the air. And
we look out in the audience and see people from different ages, different races, different denominations united together in worship.
And that's something that we get to see that somebody else probably from their perspective in the audience doesn't really get to see. So,
and being in front of so many different people from different backgrounds, different denominations coming to our concerts and kind of laying aside those denomination walls.
And I think in a way it's almost like a small glimpse of heaven.
That's kind of, you know, the idea of where Come Together really was birthed out of. I think from there it's grown.
When it was time to record the record Come Together, we talk about how cool it was to try to record in a house, but the real reason was
there was a kind of a communication breakdown.
We just hadn't booked a recording studio and we didn't have any other options. And
we wanted to record in Atlanta, but as I said earlier, nobody wanted to rent a house to a band for a
month. They wanted to rent it for a year.
So
Monroe and I, we were driving around and we found this really cool
loft apartment, very open spaces and wood floors and things like that.
Instead of even being in a studio at all and having the time pressure,
a lot of bands are going in and making their own little makeshift studio.
We just brought in all the recording gear, brought in some couches and rugs and stuff to sort of give it the vibe, if you will.
So the people who own the building were their kids were Third Day fans.
I know I said the building wasn't done, but the first floor isn't done, but the second story is done. And why don't you guys come by, because we love you guys. You guys, you know, we'd love for you guys to do it in here.
They said, man, this place is great and we can get it for a good price, but there's this hum, there's like this electrical hum. So we might not be able to record there because we won't want this hum throughout our recording. So we all looked at it and we were like, man, it's a shame. And I went, and so I listened real close and I walked around, finally found the hum. It was this little refrigerator in the corner, and just unplugged it, quiet as could be. So we ended up recording there. Spent about a month in the studio and that we made and just had a great time doing it.
I think there's this fun, creative spirit that can happen.
There was no pressure as far as watching your, you know, the clock, seeing how much time you were in there. We just did it at our leisure.
All right. Hey.
I'm still listening. When we're just being ourselves and we're not worried about the
time there at the studio, really to create, to come and go as we please, to keep kind of hours that were more refreshing.
Got the RC cam going.
Usually how we write songs is somebody in the band gets an idea and just kind of basically the song is done, but they bring that melody and progression and the lyrics to the band, and then the band just kind of puts the music to it.
Show Me Your Glory, I mean, I came up with the lyrics like just a couple of days before we went in the studio.
In the past, I've done most of the writing, but on this record, some of the other guys had a lot more songs come into the batch, which was cool because we've got some different sounds and some different ideas and things that I would never think of, which is great, which I think made the record a lot better.
I was thinking of all these words just describing God and his attributes, and I just kept going back to glory.
And so Brad, who plays guitar, and Mark, who plays guitar, both brought some great song ideas.
And it made me think of in the Old Testament where Moses is on top of the mountain and having that experience where he meets God and God shows him just his back. He just gets that glimpse of God and how his life was changed forever.
Won't rest till I see you again, yeah.
Hey everybody, it's Mac Powell here on the stage for the dress rehearsal for the Come Together tour.
How you doing? I'm Mark Lee. It's good to make your acquaintance. Thanks for coming to our show.
I expect everybody to come out and be rocked.
Started working on this in June and here we are. It's pretty exciting.
Tour all last week. And we came together, no pun intended, came together on Sunday. We're excited about what we've got. The band's excited about the material they've been working hard on. We're excited about the show.
This is a huge show, and for us is by far the biggest undertaking that we've had as far as production, sound, and lights. I think people look at us as a Christian band and go, oh, well, that's not going to be as big as a mainstream band, but you can see now behind me all the stuff that's there. The sun is on the way. Here comes the chorus. Yeah, come on, sky falls down. It crumbles down to the sea. The sun goes out. He's coming back for me. I'll be found at the place where the gravity leaves the ground.
Out of the five of us, Ty is probably the guy that gets the most excited about the production and the technical side of putting on a show.
Whenever we approach a new tour, the guys always start teasing me.
Ty was coming to us with all these drawings on napkins and on
a scrap of papers I can find, and
how he thought the show should look and how the light should be, and we were all like, okay, Ty, whatever, man, you know, you do your thing.
I have my little pens, and I'll get out a little protractor and ruler, and I start kind of sketching out and dreaming what the show can be.
He'll come up with an idea and talk with the band about it, and we'll kind of, you know, say the things we like and discuss it.
We have a show designer, Scott Moore.
I'm Scott Moore, and I'm the lighting and scenic designer for the Third Day Tour. The process for this tour was a little different than other tours that I've worked on. In this case, the band had some very strong ideas about what they wanted to see.
I actually sent them like a 12-page document with all my sketches.
Ty had some real specific ideas, which again is rather unusual for most of the artists that I work with.
And I had written out all the scenes of the show.
So my job began was to flesh out those ideas and bring them into reality, as well as create some other ideas that I had. Take all these various elements that you see behind me and make them one cohesive and workable thing that we can reproduce from night to night.
And he took that, and you know, a few days later I get back, kind of it's all drawn out to these 3D scale, and I can actually see what it's looking like, and we tweaked it and honed it in.
He knew that he wanted to see the circular trusses that we have. He knew that he wanted to see the desert background. He knew that he wanted to see the star drop. And he knew that he wanted to see the very large aluminum logo at the end of the show.
My name is Daniel Connell. I'm the lighting director for Third Day. Mainly what that entails is actually running the shows on the tour as we go along, kind of getting everything programmed, getting everything really detailed, just how we like it.
Different kinds of little gags, such as fiber optic drops and scrims that are lit up like a moon.
And on this tour, it was really cool because it was the most I felt like that I had to work with for a while.
A lot of tours and bands in this genre don't get to play around a lot with variable speed motors and trusses that move and pods that go up and down.
I'm actually excited for Ty because I feel like of any tour we've done, this is the closest to the napkin renderings that he was drawing out well before the tour started.
He had this idea, because on the record, on the cover of Come Together, there's this kind of desert scene. And we had a great
picture with us in front of the desert. And I really wanted to take the idea. I wanted people to know that they weren't just at a Third Day show, but they were at the Come Together tour. So the idea was to kind of make that desert come to life.
Man, it'd be cool to have this backdrop behind us. And then we just talked more about it and said, hey, you know what? Even more than that, let's have like a progression where it goes from the day to the
nighttime and just a real beautiful environment for the worship songs. And then, you know, almost that we've kind of gone through it and then it's almost like a brand new day.
You know, not only making the record and working with ideas and bringing those together, but also in portraying those songs through our scenes and our show.
Now put your hands together, come on. Let me hear a big woo! There was a time when I thought that I had you figured out. I told you before. When the rain comes, it seems that everyone out and search a lonely thing to do. I can't stop the rain from falling down on you again. I can't stop the rain, but I will hold you till it goes away. When the rain comes, you blame it on the things that you have done. And when the storm fades, you know that rain must fall on everyone. So rest a while. It'll be alright, and no one loves you like I do.
Grab somebody you love and sing to them.
Well, I can't stop the rain from falling down on you again. I can't stop the rain,
but I will hold you.
But I will hold you.
Can't stop the rain.
Well, I can't stop the rain from falling down on you again. I can't stop the rain, but I will hold you till it goes away. La da da, la da da. When the rain comes, well, I will hold you.
When you're doing the same thing over and over every night,
it's easy for it to wear down on you and for you to get sort of burnt out. And
there are definitely times when you kind of get tired of it.
We were out there scratching our heads going, wait a minute, you know, we're getting sidetracked. It was easy to do, you know. And that's when
our good friend Tim Cash came out with us for a few shows
to kind of lead us in studies while we're on the road.
When you love something with all your heart, it occupies much of your thoughts. You're not into comparing what you did last night. You're not comparing, man, what last year's show was. It's occupying so much of you, you're like, nothing compares to the greatness of knowing you today.
Been friends with Mac for the last year and a half, and have traveled with the guys over the last year at times, as well as just at a retreat with them.
Okay, because as you get about 5 or 6 weeks into the tour now, and as I've talked, you know, pretty much with all of you, you say, man, you're starting to get tired. You know, the freshness is starting to erode a little bit.
Just realistically, you knock out a whole lot of shows, and then you go home for a lot of time, and then you know, when you tour, you're doing lots of shows during one period of time.
We just get weary. I mean, it's not that our jobs are so hard. I mean, I think we do very little actual physical work. I mean, we get up on the stage for an hour and a half every night, and play, and
you gotta stay fresh with this stuff, but you can't force it.
It's easy to get excited for big shows if you're playing in your hometown or if you know there's gonna be a lot of people there, but when you get to some of these smaller towns,
you lose that excitement that you first had.
Sometimes we pray that God would give us His heart for the people in the audience, but almost, it's just coming to me now, so this might be raw, but it's almost like we need our audience's heart for God.
You know, they talk about people having their finest hour. I think whatever the opposite of that for us, our lowest humbling point happened on this tour. We were in
Chattanooga where we had started, played a couple songs, feeling great about the show, and then all of a sudden
the power goes out. I mean, what are you gonna do?
We need to let people know that it doesn't always work. actually an exception where it all works. This usually is what happens.
The sound goes away, the lights go away.
That their power outage needs to come out of the merch feed. You know what I'm talking about.
Right at a pinnacle where you've got the crowd, you've got momentum, that you've, it's stored energy that you're fixing to kind of take it to the next level with an audience.
I think the lights were still on, but the sound went away, so we're up there playing and nothing's coming out of the speakers. So, you know, we just rocked so hard that it just blew the circuit.
Do we ever mess up? No, absolutely not. We're professionals.
You're not supposed to capture that on camera.
Sure he is.
We never mess up.
David doesn't mess up.
David.
Yeah. I don't mess up.
You just kind of slowly step off stage and say, we'll be back. We're going to take a little intermission and hope and pray that the power comes back on soon.
Now, this is a good chance for me to learn the songs because I've been kind of butchering them. I don't know how to play this.
We tried to make light of it for a little while. We were making small talk, making jokes.
I think I went back and just beat up a crew guy or, you know, we kind of fought as a band.
Yeah, I think if it stops being fun, we're not going to do it anymore.
This is fun. This happens every night, by the way.
Well, that's why we play music, because we love music. We love being together as friends. And, you know, every night is something different.
We've always loved playing Consuming Fire. It's our favorite song. Anytime anybody asks us what our favorite song is, we always, without fail, say Consuming Fire, because it's a great song to play live.
I really felt like with worship, it's this experience where as the music you play, it's often, you know, something where it's beautiful to try to draw people in, and but why not create a visual environment?
I was on the acoustic team. I remember that for sure. A couple of us wanted to do it acoustic, do it during that acoustic set. And then the other guys were like, well, that's like the best song of the concert. We've got to do that during the rock section of the show. So there was the, is it acoustic? Is it rock?
Acoustically, I mean, I think Third Day is a rock band and we can rock. We've really never done an acoustic set per se in a show.
I said, why don't we do it both? Let's just start it off acoustically and then just finish it up with the electric.
For us, it just meant, you know, let's keep this thing as live and rocking as possible. We're just replacing, you know, amplified instruments with acoustic instruments.
We wanted to do it different for this tour, and we thought it would be really cool to do it during that acoustic set.
Still having the same attitude, maybe having a little more fun because we're a little tighter, you know, on the stage. We're a little closer together.
But it turned out really cool, and I love it. I think it's best part of the show.
This is the very first song that we ever played as a five-piece band together. We're gonna do it for y'all right now. It goes like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This place on fire, send your spirit, Savior, rescue from the mire, show your servant, play the Lord. Yesterday was the day that I was alone, now I'm in the presence of Almighty God. Yes, set this place on fire, send your spirit to your own.
rescue for all of my own. Show your servant favor, Lord. Yesterday was the day that I was alone. Now I'm in the presence of Almighty God. Yes, our God, He is a consuming fire in the flesh. Burn down deep in my soul. Yes, our God, He is a consuming fire. He reaches inside and it fills down His cold heart stone. The Junior loves that inside of you, there is a flame. Did you ever try to let it burn? You let it burn, you let it burn. Yeah. Y'all sing it loud now. Yes, all God. Young flames deep in my soul. Oh, yes, our God. Our God, He is a consuming. Down this cold heart of stone. He's a fire. Yeah. Yes, our God. He's a fire. Crucified, baby. I believe what I believe. again. He ascended into heaven, where he sits at God's mighty right hand. And I believe that he's returning to judge the quick and the dead and the sons of men. And I believe what I believe, that's why it makes me what I am. No, I did not make it. No, it is making me. It is the very truth of God, and I think that shine of any man. Well, I believe it. Oh, I said I believe it. Yes, I believe.
Of truth.
sing, turn your eyes upon Jesus. Amen.
On this tour, we wanted to do something that was more than just playing some music.
So with that, we formed a relationship with Habitat for Humanity.
They embody the idea of coming together more than any organization I could think of.
For us, I think Habitat was a great match for that.
The whole idea of come together and people uniting to accomplish something.
And so this is something that Third Day's not doing alone. We're doing it with our fans. And so most of all, thanks to our fans for helping to raise this money.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
When the rain comes, it seems that everyone has gone away. When the night falls, you wonder if you shouldn't find some place to run and hide, escape.
Ladies and gentlemen, David Carr is about to use the nail gun.
Okay. Make sure
you get
that. You could tell they were good Christian people. The way they act and the way they wait. They what they did from their heart.
We didn't want it to just be an abstract idea. We wanted it to be something that this record, and specifically this tour, had a lasting impact. That it wouldn't just be a year of work and then it's just gone.
This would be a perfect thing for us to do on the Come Together tour.
Where we could, you know, invest our time, invest our resources.
It was amazing to see how quickly our involvement with Habitat grew.
We were going to take a dollar from every ticket that was purchased
to go to a fund for Habitat
to build 3 houses in the U.S. and 5 houses in other countries around the world.
And before we know it, we do a whole tour with them. And then Ty and I had the opportunity to go to South Africa last summer.
You know, I love South Africa. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful country.
We got here about 2 days ago.
If I was smart, I'd grab about 6 of them and just do it all at once. Not smart.
I think you guys got it on footage a minute ago. I was going to get some nails.
I just need some more of the other side that he just got.
And I didn't have a tool belt or anything, so before I knew it, I had this big pile of nails, like in my shirt here. That was kind of interesting, I gotta say.
It's fun to be part of a project. We're pretty much from the ground up. You're building a house.
It's just amazing, like, how they've got this set up and organized down to every detail. But yeah, it's been really great just to see and be a part of. So Habitat for Humanity is a great organization for us to be working with. I think it just meets the needs of what Come Together needs to be.
In reality, the outcome of it is huge, because it is a tangible thing for a family to be able to have a decent home to live in.
I thank God for being so tremendously good. I thank God because Habitat itself, it means life. You know, I praise God that He's blessed us and He kept us. I mean, I was praying. I said, Lord God, I just believe that we're going to have our own home. And I thank God for just bringing that about.
What really gets me excited about that is that, you know, when Third Day is gone and our records are just on the $3.99 shelf at the truck stop, there's still going to be families throughout the United States and all around the world that are living in homes for the first time.
We have 5 different guys in the band, but realizing that we all, as a band, we need to come together, put aside the little differences that we have personality-wise. We've learned a lot through that.
We think Third Day really models the come together idea of unifying, because we all come from different denominations. Growing up, we all went to different churches, and when we came together as a band, and tried to accomplish something, tried to make some music that glorifies God and reaches people and gives people hope, encourages people. You know, we set aside all the small differences that we might disagree about and really focused on the thing that brought us together, and that was our faith in Jesus.
If we focus on the important things, we're united and we're stronger. The Bible says that a house divided will not stand.
So I feel like we've learned a lot from each other over the years, and hopefully that's something that we can set an example for other people. You know, if we're able to do it, the five of us are able to put aside those differences, hopefully some other people can as well.
That message of come together, of unity, is going to be something that we're always talking about, because we see it so much, how God has worked through unity within our own bands.
We want to see people to draw a little bit closer to God, whether they're fired up, full-on Christian, or whether they're not a Christian at all. Hopefully we can encourage people just to think about God and to dig in a little bit deeper with their faith.
This idea of come together, though, is something that, I mean, is going to carry with us.
We had no idea when we first heard the song or when we were demoing it that it was going to turn into this album and this whole theme with a tour and everything.
This tour has really been something that we've been living now for 2 years, just from the first idea of coming together and starting to record and then taking and dreaming up what this tour could be, and now a whole year of doing these shows.
And so it's something that I want to continue to take from this, to continue to remain unified and to always work on that.
We got to come together, 'cause in the end we can make it all right.
Leave y'all with a brand new song tonight. It's the last song on the record, Come Together. The words are nothing compares to the greatness of knowing you, Lord. Nothing compares to the greatness of knowing you, Lord. Sing it with us.
Nothing compares to the greatness of knowing you, Lord. Nothing compares to the great. I've heard all the stories, I've seen all the signs. Will no star the glory, tasted all this fire, but nothing compares to the greatness of knowing you, Lord. Oh no, nothing compares to the greatness of knowing.
Those words that were spoken and written by the great Apostle Paul, they apply just as much to our lives today as they did 2,000 years ago when he wrote them. That in our lives, no matter where we go, or what we could see, or who we could meet, or what we could accomplish or be given to us or earn, there's nothing in this world that will ever come close to the greatness of knowing Jesus Christ our Lord. He writes those words, the Apostle Paul does, in Philippians chapter 3. And he talks about all the things in his life that he had gone through and how he was raised in the right family, raised in the right way, according to God's law, that nobody could find anything ever wrong with him. But he said, when I came to know the grace and the mercy of Jesus, that's when I found out what true life was. And he said, all my accomplishments, all the things that I had ever done or could ever do, I considered them garbage compared to knowing Jesus. He says, it's a priceless gain to know him. In other words, there is nothing in our lives that we shouldn't be willing to let go of in order to be closer to him. And Jesus himself said, if you're going to follow me, he says, you must die to yourself daily. Take up your cross and follow me. He says, if you try to hold on to even one small part of your life, you're going to lose it. But he says, if you lose your life for my sake, for me, Jesus said, that's when you gain real life, real joy, real peace, through him alone. And so the invitation tonight is not given by me, it's not given by Third Day. The invitation is given by Jesus himself. When he says, all of you who are weary and heavy laden, all of you with burdens, he says, come to me and I will give you rest. All of you with doubts and fears, he says, come to me, I will give you answers, I will give you peace. All of you with hurts, come to me and I will heal you. Come to me and I will give you life, Jesus says. He says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no man can get to the Father but through me. And so that's why we're here tonight. To tell people about him and about his great love. To tell people that to us he is a priceless gain. There's nothing more important than knowing Jesus. And us guys in this band, we, as I told you earlier, we've been around this world. We've been across the U.S. so many times, we've lost count. We've seen and done a lot of different things. But there's nothing that compares to the greatness of knowing Jesus Christ our Lord. I find myself just living for today, 'cause I don't know what tomorrow's gonna bring. So no matter if I rise or fall, I'm not afraid to
guys, wake up. I'm sleeping on the job.
Come on, man, let's get to work.
See what happens? I can't take them anymore.
We can rock, acoustic, electric, whatever you think. If he gave us, you know, maybe kazoos, I'm not sure we could rock.
Yeah, the interface, we've got a flux line running, you know, plumb to the 30-degree parallel, but,
Now, I see you chose a pine trim.
Yeah.
Any particular reason?
The old open in the closet trick, it just never gets old.
Every time, like, I go to do the last strum.
I learned a few things. I learned how to use the saw?
Miter saw.
The miter saw. I never used a nail gun before. That was a lot of fun.
Yeah, I didn't get to use the nail gun. I learned to do that.
Yeah, I learned how to use the miter saw.
It's cool. Awesome.
Well, I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
What you looking at?
I think they might. They think that they're ready, but no, nobody's ready for this. Yeah, we're not ready, so how could they be ready? It's going to be huge. And we always like to call our concerts a rock and roll extravaganza.
It finally is.
And I think it finally really is, so it's going to be pretty rocking.
We're doing it, man. We're doing it.
Gonna finish the deal. You know, just my whole time in my mind, I've been thinking like Tiger Woods, you gotta finish the deal.